Hello, how there? I'm Tolu Alabi, and it's a new year, so many things are happening, but I just want to advise you before we start rolling into the new year properly to know the importance of relationship. Today I want to talk about relationship, and by the way, you can go on my website if you want to know more about what I do and relationship issues. Just go to www.toluallabi.org. So we're talking about relationship. What is the importance of relationship? Before we start having new relationship, we have new year resolutions and so on like that. Why is it important to be careful about the kind of relationship you get into? The reason is because relationship can either make you or destroy you. Relationship can either build you up, build your life and destiny up, or destroy you. Well, no one is born as an island. God intends, you know, that we interact with people, we have relationship, you have parents, you have brothers, you have sisters, but most especially also is love relationship. I always say something, you know, like when God was to create everything, He created things and said, let there be light, and there was light, and every other thing. But when God was gonna make something more important than the things that He had created, He said, let us. Genesis 1:26. Let us. Who was He talking to? He was talking to the Son and the Holy Spirit. So in life, whenever we want to produce something good or live a life that is worthy, then we need more than ourselves. We need relationship. We need people that makes us laugh. Yeah, sometimes people that makes us mad as well, because, you know, it's all part of life. Relationship is very important. For singles that are trusting God, you know, like this year, you're going to meet your right partner, you're going to get married, and so on like that. Understand what relationship is. I say relationship can destroy you, or relationship can make you. How can relationship make you? When you are in a right relationship, you have a sense of fulfillment. You're joyful, you're happy, you're stressless. That doesn't mean there's perfect relationship, but I'm talking about most of the time. Good relationship helps you to build something great for your life. Good relationship will encourage you to fulfill your divine purpose, to fulfill your dreams, to achieve your goal. Those are the things that good relationship will do for you. Good relationship moves you forward, moves you higher in life, gives you progress in life. But bad relationship can destroy you. Several years ago, I got into a particular prison to do a form of outreach, and then I met a girl, and the girl got into that prison because of a wrong relationship. I mean, there are thousands of such, thousands of examples to talk about, even in our lives, the relationships that we have been into that were wrong, that we probably didn't know that this relationship was wrong. Those relationships drain you. Because there's always strife. All the time you ought to spend building your life, building your career, those are the times that you're spending crying. Those are the times you're spending drained and stressed out. Those are bad relationships. You need to check before you get into any relationship. What am I looking for in this relationship? Are we going on the same way in life? Do we want to achieve the same thing? I mean, I don't mean like, okay, you want to be a medical doctor, the other person wants. No, what I'm saying is that, are we going on the same path of progress? I never forget, like some years back, you know, I used to be in the circle of friends, and everything seems well from the beginning. Okay, wonderful people, they're Christian, we're good. You know, but over time, I realized that the relationship started draining me. They're wonderful people. They're still wonderful people, but it's just probably at that particular time, we were not even supposed to connect for too long, you know, because anything I say, they misunderstand it. oh yeah, Tolu did this wrong, Tolu did that, you know. So every time I had to keep explaining myself, this is what I say, this is what I didn't mean, and so on like that. And at the end of the day, I told myself, if I continue, I'm either going to end up in bitterness, you know, or things like that, you know, because the relationship was draining. You need to be around people that bring out the best in you. I remember when I was gonna get married, and my father in the Lord then, of blessed memory now, you know, Reverend Pastor D.S. Adams, said something to me when I said, okay, I found the person, and then I talked to him about it, you know, in his office, and we were chatting about it. And he said something to me, which was the same thing he repeated when he met my husband. He said, there is a fire of God inside of you. I don't want you to marry a man that will not support the dream, but quench the fire. Which is true. There are people that comes into your life and things start going down for you. You're not on fire like you used to be. You're not producing your best like you used to be. Then those are not the people that you should hang around the most. Relationship is not perfect, but at least walk on the road to perfection. Take the route of perfection rather than engaging in people that are going to bring you down. You need to be careful of the people that are around you. Some people are like, okay, yeah, he's not good, she's not good, it doesn't matter, I know where to draw the line. No, there's going to be a time in your life when you desperately need advice. It will be the relationship you are into that is going to feed you that advice. What is that going to be like? I always tell myself, I said, don't stay around people that just want to tolerate you. Stay around people that celebrate you. Stay around people that appreciate your worth, and both of you can talk, you know, great things that you want to achieve. Not people like you want to talk about, oh, I'm having this dream, and they're like, oh, who says that's going to work? That never works. Yeah, some people can be good, make that statement one time, make that statement two times, but once it is a consistent thing, then you know that that is not the kind of people you are supposed to consistently relate with. Hang around people that will build you this year, people that will bring out the best in you. It's not just about feeling, even for love relationship. Oh, I feel good about this person. Oh, I just feel love about the person. No, it's when you get into deeper relationship, that love is not just the only thing that keeps the relationship fruitful. It's when both of you can fulfill destiny, when you can help one another to fulfill destiny, then it makes the relationship a healthy one. So this year, be careful. You can weed things out. Relationship that is not built in your life, you don't have to continue with it. Ask God how you need to go about it. It's your choice. It's your call. You make the call. And I know by the end of this year, your life will be, you will have multiplied greatly. You will have been fruitful in every good work. And you will be taking dominion and having accelerated progress in the name of Jesus. Again, I'm Tolu Alabi. Go on my website, www.toluallabi.org. There's so much there for you. Go on my YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you. Till I send another video your way, Jesus loves you.